Well then, Olivia, talk to me.
Yes. In the beginning, Nick only went to the gallery during the day. But he went so often, at some point he became friendly with Diane. They started going out drinking together, and now he doesn't come home until early morning. Sally says that they were only drinking when I asked. He blames me for not being able to talk about Turner and Rembrandt, which of course I can't, can I? So what can I say? Finally, I couldn't take it anymore, so I followed him. He did go to the bar, to start with. Diane was there too, but the real problem is where they go to next, right? So I waited outside the bar to see where they might go. And they eventually left the bar and headed for the art gallery. But it was already early morning, but it was still dark. Just before going inside, Diane turned around. It should have been too dark to see me, but I swear, her eyes looked right at me. They seemed to flash for a moment. I was so rattled that I left and went home. The next day, Anna was found dead. I didn't know what to do. I went to the gallery to talk with Diane about it, to confront her. But once I was there, I couldn't find the courage to go through with it. Then I saw you there, and I just felt I had to go home. Nick has been seeing Diane every night recently. He just left for tonight, too. I really don't know what to do.
York, we ought to take Nick in for questioning.
No, not yet. This alone isn't enough.
Emily, answer me.
This is Emily. Agent York is with me, too.
I've just received word from Thomas at the Sheriff's Department. Something has happened at Becky's house. He was called in by Quint, but he wasn't making any sense. We have no further details. I've sent Thomas over there. Can you go back him up?
Yes, sir.
One other thing. It sounded like he said, raincoat killer. This may well be related to the murder case. Take all due precautions.
No! It couldn't be! Nick! Oh, please, no! What can I do? Nick!
Olivia, calm down.
Emily, take care of Olivia. I'm heading over to bed.
She lives in the big house over by the lake. Hurry!
I just hope this isn't anything serious. Damn it, Zach. We may have screwed up during the investigation. say since I got here. Quint, tell me, what did you see in there? Did you see the rainbow killer?
Them!
Thomas, did you see Nick here? No. When I got here, he was already like this. He should be here soon. Call George and tell him to get over. Wait out here. I'm going inside. Once they both get here, follow George's orders, okay?
Yes. But Agent York, isn't it dangerous to go in there alone?
Don't worry. Zach is with me. Zach, let me smoke one first. I need to clear my head so I can take everything in. Too much noise. We're still missing a vital piece of the puzzle.
Thank you.
We'll be right back. Great.
Zach, this is a waste of time. Let's go. Very bad, Zach. The raincoat killer gave Becky a visit. Hold on. Quick! Zach, she's still alive.
Who did this? Who was it, Becky?
Becky! What happened here?
George, stay back. She's trying to speak.
We don't have time! She's dying! Thomas, cut that wire.
No!
We must get her to the hospital immediately.
What?
What?
What are you doing? Get out of the way! I'll do it!
No, don't! George, stop! Got us good this time, Zach. My dear sister, I'm so, so sorry. I was a fool to fall for a man like him. I don't have the words to apologize to Anna.
left her there. She was suffering so much, and I just ran away. I know he wanted to kill me too, but I'm not going to let him get away with this. I followed him after he was finished. He carried Anna into the woods. Anna was holding on to that precious locket of his. He couldn't remove it from her hand, even though she was dead. But she let go of it for me, though. It was like she gave it to me. So I brought it home. I might be able to bring Anna's killer down with it. I want you to see it. I know even he wouldn't dare to harm you. He'll catch me, though, if I go into town. I'm trapped in my house. So I've asked Isaac and Isaiah to deliver it. They totally believe that Anna became a goddess. I believe so, too. She looked so beautiful, as though she might smile back at any moment. I have something else to confess to you. I borrowed a pair of your shoes without asking and broke the heel on one of them. I'll send them along with the locket. I'm sure the shoe can be fixed.
So Becky is Miss Stiletto Heel, and she gave the locket to the twins. Must be the special secret Billy told us about, Zach. We better go and see her first thing tomorrow. Emily, who might this sister be that Becky was referring to here?
That would be Diane. Didn't you know Diane and Becky were sisters?
Should have known, Zach.